good morning, world.
I feel like having a walk this morning before I do my vlog today. I could do with a nice walk and maybe nick to town as well as go to Tesco's as well. Feels like a usual Monday, but I feel like walking.
I'm the type of guy that likes to roam around. I'm never in one place. I roam from town to town because I'm a wanderer.
It's a vlog.
It's good to have a walk, keep myself a bit active and somewhat fit anyways. But yeah, it's just nice to wander around and all that, especially wandering around when it comes to like Fallout 4, which I'm looking forward to doing, because I love wandering around when it comes to doing stuff on Fallout 3 plus Fallout New Vegas. I'm looking forward to Fallout 4. It's going to be great just wandering around doing stuff that is doing the main quest, because he does the main quest these days. Anyways, hi, I'm Steven, welcome to CT Films. It's a vlog. So, what videos I did this past 1 week? I did a few videos this past 1 week, even though one of which I was expecting to do after work on Wednesday and then do a video then because I was in no rush to do it. But for some odd reason, I kind of got it a day early since I kind of pre-ordered it and preloaded it on my Xbox, and that was the Back to the Future game that came out this past 1 week, since it's been out officially on Xbox platforms, on the Golden Xbox One, and I thought I'd do some Xbox One gameplay for you guys, and it got quite past no review, which is good, which I'm pleased of, because I wanted to do some gameplay, let alone, as you may know, I sometimes do some Xbox One gameplay of certain games that either re-released or ported or whatever, and I like doing them sort of videos, and it gets people viewing, which is good because I like doing that. But overall, it was a good video to do overall, and despite though I didn't get any achievements because the achievements were kind of disabled because I kind of got a day early, I don't know the issue, but it was nice to get a day early, let alone I think it's due to the US date, I don't know. But overall, it was just nice to get unlocked and plus do that video, and then it saves me doing it when I finish after work on the Wednesday anyways. And then on the same day, the Destiny update came out this past 1 week, because I've been playing Destiny quite a lot lately, and the recent update came out, and I thought I'd do some gameplay plus some commentary and explain about the whole microtransactions type thing. I've seen some YouTube videos already talked about this, and I thought I'd pitch in and do a video for myself since I've been playing Destiny quite a bit, and plus I wanted to show my character that I've been working on Destiny for the past few months since I've been playing Destiny, even though somewhat noobish. But yeah, just nice though, and to try out the Destiny update, even though I was trying to get a particular dance move, but I haven't got enough silver because I didn't read it properly and I was being a bit stupid. And the funny thing is though, I was being a bit awkward at the end of the video, because I didn't realise on the price of the legendary dance move than it is than the rare dance moves. And then the blooming capture card, knowing my crud PC, cut off at the end, which was dead funny at the end of the video. But overall, it was just nice to do that video overall. So yeah, those are the videos I did this past 1 week. So for this vlog, I thought I'd show you some pickups I got this past 1 week, because I've been to my local Cash Converters, because I haven't been to Cash Converters. Well, not saying I haven't been to Cash Converters, I always nip into Cash Converters, but there was nothing interesting to buy in Cash Converters. But even though then sometimes in Cash Converters, sometimes in my local Cash Converters, they sometimes do some really cheap Xbox One games, and I actually got one, which I'll show you in a minute. But I actually picked this up, because it's been a while since I picked up an Xbox 360 game, let alone getting another Xbox 360 game, even though I used to have this Xbox 360 game. But it's nice to own this again, which I'll explain in a minute, and some other things which I'll explain in a minute. But yeah, anyways, so yes, I actually got a copy of Gears of War, the limited edition, which looks really, really cool this is, and I got this for a real good price of £4. Now, I bet you're thinking, Steven, have you already got Gears of War? Let alone you already got Gears of War remastered and, you know, and all that on the Xbox One. I'm like, yeah, I do. But it's just that I did have a physical copy of Gears of War 1, and not the limited edition, but the normal edition that I already had. But for some odd reason, knowing back in the old days with ex-housemates and friends and all that, for some reason the disc on the physical copy has got nicked,
I still have the case upstairs in my bedroom, but it's just it didn't have the disc, so yeah, long story short. And I do have a digital copy of it, of the first game, and I got that with my copy of Gears of War Judgment, because when you get Gears of War Judgment, you get a digital copy of the first Gears of War game. Sorry, I'm rambling on too much, but you get what I'm trying to say. But I got the limited edition of Gears of War 1. It's in really good condition, it is, which is really, really nice, because the sleeve is in not bad condition, plus the tin is in not bad condition. I don't see any bumps, because usually when you get like steelbook type things, usually they have like bumps. If they bashed it quite badly, they usually have a bump. But the content inside is alright, because if I quickly show you, if I can grab it all out. But the game itself type thing is a bit bumped. It's got some bumps here and there, even though it's all paper and stuff. But the content inside is good. Now, the thing is, though, long story short, I've mentioned about this on an Instagram post when I got the latest update for my Xbox 360. But long story short, as I mentioned a few vlogs back when I recently put a 1TB hard drive onto my Xbox 360, I had a bit of an issue with my Xbox 360 because it would not read my discs for some odd reason. I didn't know if there was a bug during a preview test or something, and there was something, not saying, well, I have got access to the preview program on the Xbox 360, but I haven't got it on my Xbox 360. Another long story short. But it's just, I thought there would be a technical issue doing that, but I realised after playing the DVD of the limited edition of Gears of War, as well as playing the actual game itself, I realised, I think it's my laser on my Xbox 360, it's been burnt out again, because, you know, I got that fixed a few years ago, when my Xbox 360 was in limbo, and I had a laser fix and all that, and it was working fine for a few years, and then I got my Xbox One and all that hibbery jibbery stuff, long story short. And but yeah, they were not working on my Xbox 360. But however, luckily when I'm on the Xbox One preview program, I can use the backwards compatibility. And luckily the DVD works on the Blu-ray app, as well as the game works as well, which is good. I haven't installed it, even though I do have a digital copy. But I uninstalled the digital copy, then test out the disc, and it was reading on the Xbox One, so I know it works. So regardless, it's nice to have both the physical and digital copy, but it's just nice overall. And it does come with a manual, nice colourful manual, which is good. And plus the art book, because I did do some research on the internet just to make sure that I got all the content. I actually got the full content. And the art book is really nice, and it is not damaged at all. It's nice and colourful, as you can see. But yeah, just overall, in a nutshell, it's great to get a limited edition copy in really good condition as well. And I'll put that with my Xbox 360 collection. But like I said beforehand, even though my Xbox 360 is in limbo, but it's nice to have a physical copy again of Gears of War. And it will go nicely with my Xbox 360 collection. It will work on my Xbox One, so to say, even though I'll have the first game multiple times, having it physically, digitally, then digitally again, whenever they do a thing with the Gears of War Ultimate Edition, where basically you can get all the other Gears games for free digitally. I don't know when they're ever going to do that. Maybe when the new update in November, as well as backwards compatibility, whenever that comes out. But regardless, it's just nice to get this overall. Sorry for rambling on too much about that. Anyways. So yeah, speaking about Xbox One games, not only that I got that from Cash Converters, because I didn't know to pick this up in Cash Converters, but the reason why I've been to Cash Converters is to get this, and it's Dying Light on Xbox One for £15. It's not bad buy, because usually this costs about like £20 to £25. It's usually quite expensive, even though I heard you can get quite cheap in the Asda's clearance, but I didn't manage to get a copy in the Asda's clearance in my local Asda's, long story short. But overall, it's just nice to get a copy, and I'm really looking for, not looking forward to what I'm saying, I'm really enjoying playing it, because I mentioned a few vlogs back about I actually played the demo for this, because they launched a demo a few months after when the game came out, knowing developers these days, and I really enjoyed the demo, and I really regretted myself, I mentioned about on my that vlog in general, that I really regretted on getting Dying Light than it is on that particular month. I got Evolve instead of Dying Light, and I really regret myself on that. But now it's nice to actually own the copy and actually got it this year, since it came out this year. But yeah, it's just nice to get this overall, especially whenever the new DLC does come out. And I heard, because I actually liked them on Facebook, so I could get updates about the new DLC. And the following DLC will be coming out in Q4 2016, so I'm not late to the pie for that DLC, and I thought it would come out at the end of this month, let alone and this year in general. But still, I've been looking forward to that DLC whenever that comes out, which is understandable, because I just thought at the top of my head just now, it's nice to delay that, because knowing the holiday rush and all the upcoming games and whatnot, it's understandable why they had to delay that DLC overall. But still, however, it's just nice to get this though. In case you haven't played this game yet, do try out the demo on your Xbox One or PlayStation 4, or I'm not so sure on PC. But yeah, just nice to get this overall. The content inside, however, which is quite funny really, because it did came with some codes, so to say. But sadly, the codes did not work on my Xbox One, because they've already been used, sadly. So in case you were trying to redeem these, they're already used. But besides though, you can get the Be the Zombie DLC for free, even if you didn't pre-order the game or whatever. No pre-orders these days. Oh, we've released this game for many, many months now. Let's release the pre-order bonus for free type thing. I like it when you got to love it when developers do that. But overall, it's nice to get a cheap copy of this. Even though I will regret this even more when this will get a bit cheaper soon. Because the last time I picked up a Xbox One game in cash converters, which was Assassin's Creed 4, which I got quite cheap, because it was like £20 to £25 at the time. I got it for £15. Same thing with this. And I knew at some point it will be like cheaper than this in stores, and then before you know it, it might be free with Games with Gold, like it did with them Assassin's Creed 4, which I will regret though, but still, however, it's nice to get a cheap copy of this. But overall, yes, that's the pickups that I got, the cash converter pickups that I got this past 1 week from cash converters. It was just nice to get some pickups from cash converters. Oh yeah, and speaking about the used codes on Dying Light, something happened this past 1 week, because one day I went to my nearest shops near where I live, and I found this on the street, which was dead funny. And I know if you saw my social networking sites, you already know, but I'll quickly show you anyways. I found this in the streets, and this was a thing, and as you can see, it's got a code, but it's already been used. Sadly, the code's already been used, but it's just funny finding this on the floor. No in chess today. Oh, innit, mate? Playing some FIFA. Oh, I don't need this no more, because I've already redeemed it. Innit, my days. But yeah, overall, it's just nice to find this, weirdly, even though the game's already been out for a few days now. But yeah, it's just dead funny to find this overall. And speaking about FIFA in general, I was playing FIFA 15 on my Windows phone, and I had a lucky pot, because I bought a 7.5k pack, you know, a normal premium gold pack on FIFA, and I was lucky, very lucky, to get this. I got an Inform. I know you can't see this book because it's a blurry in the camera, but I took a screenshot of it on my social networking sites. But yeah, it was just nice to get an Inform. I showed my friend it, who plays FIFA a lot, who has the same needs I have, but he was like, oh, that's nice, even though that FIFA kind of sucks, even though, as you can not know, there was an update for FIFA 15, and plus other platforms like iOS and Android had like a new look that looks like FIFA 16 for some odd reason. But yeah, long story short, let alone FIFA 16 still hasn't came out on Windows Phone yet. But regardless, it was just nice to get that overall. But yeah, those are the things that happened this past 1 week. Even though I would like to get, however, because I was thinking of getting a new mouse and keyboard set, because I mentioned about this to someone I was chatting on an Xbox Live party with, and I mentioned that to him, and I just thought I'd quickly say that I didn't feel like getting it, you know, now, because I was thinking about buying it this past 1 week, but I decided not to. The reason why I wanted to get, though, is because, long story short, because they haven't, because the mouse and keyboard set that I have has, like, different logos and all that than it is the newer logos that Microsoft have. And I wanted a new mouse and keyboard set anyway, so I thought I'd give the old ones I have now and give them to my Xbox One once the mouse and keyboard support comes out on Xbox One. That is if they support this mouse and keyboard set, even though it's a Microsoft product one. But we'll have seen the outcome. I might buy it later on. They might do it on sale. And maybe whenever I do get my new PC at some point, I might pick up the mouse and keyboard set. Well, I'll see in the outcome, let alone I just do not know if I will be getting a new PC for Christmas. I'm still discussing it with my mum still. Anyways, I'm rambling on too much about that. But however, I did pick up some Amazon credit, which I would show you some pickups that I actually got this past 1 week that came in the post. But if you follow up on my social networking sites, you already know in advance. But I will showcase it on my next vlog, because I need to get something sewed up, because knowing my mum does my sewing. But I need something that needs patching up, so to say. But I'm looking forward to showing you that on my next vlog. But yeah, those are the kind of pickups and things I would mind picking up, but I didn't end up picking up, and some things that happened this past 1 week, so yeah. The lighting was a bit on and off today, because I had to keep shutting and closing my doors, and now there's a black cloud over my house, and yeah. Anyways, what I've been up to this past 1 week, I've been doing some socialising, which is quite good. First of which, as I mentioned briefly on my last vlog, that I was going to play and the Star Wars Battlefront Bay with someone, because I mentioned on my last vlog that someone was messaging me to play with this person, and I was recording my vlog, so we decided to do it on Saturday instead, and we had a great time playing the Star Wars Battlefront Bay, as well as not only with him but his friend, and we played Halo the Master Collection. We've been talking about video games, YouTube. It was great socializing. It was great, nice then doing that. And it was just nice overall. It was really, really good. I really enjoyed that. And the funny thing is, though, that happened this past 1 week. After when I picked up my pickups from Cash Converters this past 1 week, the other thing is, when I was in town, I was need to pick up my medication that day, but I forgot to pick it up, so I picked it up the day after. And when I was picking up my medication, and there was a staff member in Granger Games, who I think is the manager, because he wears like a polo shirt and all that. I think that's why he's the manager, because he wears a polo shirt. But it's just, I know I chat to the staff now and again. It's just that I think the manager and said, I listened to your podcast and all that. I was like, are you talking about me? My videos and all that. I do vlogs, I do, let alone video logs. But I can understand the confusion, because I know most of you, sometimes, even though it's a video log, and sometimes you guys listen to my vlogs as like a podcast sort of thing. Not judging anyone, but I know most people do. Which I can understand the confusion, but it's just funny. He actually found my YouTube channel, and he actually we had a bit of discussion about my past things with YouTube and what I do on YouTube and all types of stuff. We had a little conversation, even though I was a bit awkward and a bit embarrassed. But it's good, though. Like, it's nice that my local Granger Games is kind of watching my videos, even though I've been in a few times this past 1 week, and I'm surprised I didn't say, oh, look, it's that guy that makes YouTube videos that comes to our store regularly and stuff. Is dead funny, though. In case you are watching this, sorry, I'm talking about that, even though I can be a bit awkward and all that, let alone the speech that I am in general, let alone my socialising in general. But it was just a funny thing overall. It's just nice how that, you know, and all that, and nice that, because I know that some people in Grimsby sometimes finds my YouTube channel and talks about it, and oh, that was just nice. I haven't got like a big fan base in Grimsby, but it's just nice to like certain people find my YouTube channel and all that. Even though I do have my 3DS and I do advertise my YouTube channel, my 3DS when I street pass people. It could have been that, but you know, regardless. But yeah, anyways. But other than that, though, I've been fine and dandy. I've been off work this past 1 week since it was my last day at work for the half-term holidays for Halloween, which was quite nice. And I'm looking forward to, well, I'm saying looking forward to. I keep thinking I'm going to have a boring half-term, even though I'm looking forward to Halo 5, as well as I'm not so sure what I'm going to be doing for Halloween, let alone a Halloween special in general. But yeah, just this and that. And yeah, I'm just fine and dandy. I'm going to go frozen food shopping either tonight or tomorrow night. And because the funny thing is though, when I was an Xbox Live partying with that someone when I was playing Star Wars Battlefront, my mum texted me, it's like, do you want to go food shopping and stuff? And I was like, no, I'm playing with someone. And all that's dead funny. Because sometimes my mum goes out on the Saturday, she asked if she wanted to tag along, even though I didn't want any food shopping. But however, my frozen foods is low again, and I need to stock up on frozen foods again, so I need to go frozen food shopping at some point with mum on either tonight or tomorrow night. Anyways, I'm rambling on too much. I wanted to ramble on some things that's been happening with life. Anyways, let alone some things that happened this past 1 week. Yeah, I'm rambling on too much anyways. Anyways, what videos I'll be doing next week? It'll be my 9-year anniversary on YouTube, which will be happening on Monday, next Monday, which I'm looking forward to kind of doing. I'll still do a video regardless. I like doing these sort of videos every year, even though I can be a bit dull, you know, because I always do a dull video every year when it comes to my anniversary videos. But I'll still make one regardless. I'll pre-record it tomorrow on Saturday and get that done and do that on Monday. Because the reason why I want to pre-record it on Saturday, because I'm getting a certain new thing, you know, and rather pre-record on Saturday so it's done, and then I can get something done on Sunday, and then I can upload on Monday sort of thing. But yeah, overall, I'm looking forward to doing anniversary video, even though it will be a bit dull, but I'll still do a video regardless, just say, yeah, I've been doing this for 9 years now, blah, 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 you know, ramble on like I usually do. Anyways. And also the other thing that comes out next week in the US, and that is a Xbox adapter for Windows 10 to be able to use a Xbox One controller for your desktop on Windows 10. It comes out on the 20th in the US, but I'm not so sure when it comes out in Europe, in the UK as well, because I do not know if it comes out next week or the week before. But regardless, we'll see on the outcome. I might do a video on that and maybe purchase that, let alone purchase a mouse and keyboard set. Anyways, anyways, I'm rambling on too much now. It's getting quite long. This is like over 25 minutes, I'm guessing. But yeah, anyways, I'm rambling on too much now. So that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you really enjoy and watch to the end of understanding. I know you guys have a really nice weekend and all that. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.